Hey, what's going on, Renaissance Lifers? I'm just here in my office slash reading room. Just wanted to come to you today with a really quick message about self-care and the importance of self-care. So I just came back from taking the family car to take an oil change. So what happened was, for a couple of days there was a message saying that maintenance is required soon. So I kept seeing this message and it kind of gave me an indication that, okay, I should probably take this car in at some point. Each time I would get into the car, because it said maintenance required soon, I just kind of kept putting it off. So eventually I get into the car one day and the message that's on the screen says maintenance required. And that message would not leave. So typically when I would turn on the car and actually start driving, that maintenance required soon would go away. But now that sign was there constantly all the time, reminding me that the car needed maintenance. So I scheduled an appointment and took it in for an oil change and regular maintenance. And my wife gave me the idea of making a video talking about the importance of maintenance in our own lives. And we like to call this self-care of different sorts. So I want to start with asking a question. Sometimes I ask, how are you? And I tag on the word really to the end of it. So how am I really? Like, not how am I just in general, but really, how am I doing? How am I feeling? And so when you take the time to ask yourself, how are you really? That will give you an opportunity to think about your feelings, your emotions, your state of being, and yourself as a whole, as opposed to just sort of thinking about, am I hungry? Am I sleepy? And while those things are important, you want to start thinking about your holistic being. So when it comes to self-care, there are several areas that we want to look at. We want to look at the emotional, we want to look at the spiritual, we want to look at the physical, and we also want to look at the relational. So when you go down those lists of things, you want to ask yourself, how are you feeling emotionally? And whether there are things that you need to resolve, is there baggage? Are there emotions that you're dealing with that are weighing you down daily? Resolve those, take care of those, figure out what that is. Take the time to think about them, talk about them, share them with somebody if that's what it takes for you to be able to move on from them. So that way you can live a more complete and content life. And that won't be something that's constantly bogging you down on a daily basis. When you ask yourself, how are you relationally? Think about your relationships. Think about the people that you know and that you have in your life. Are you in a good place with these people? And what that means is not necessarily, do all those people like you and do all those people approve of what you're doing, but are you in a place of contentment where you can be happy with your decisions? Are you making decisions for you and your family with regard to those relationships with those people? At some point and at some level, we're gonna have to be okay with people not necessarily agreeing with the decisions we make and not supporting us 100% of the way. But we wanna be at a place where we're content and that's not something that costs us sleep at the end of the night. Now, on the subject of sleep, when we talk about self-care, we also wanna think about the physical. And sleep is a big portion of that. Now, sleep varies from person to person and you can get by with little to no sleep, but a lot of times that will catch up with you. So even if you're not getting a ton of sleep, like let's say 8 to 10 hours, you want to make sure that the sleep that you are getting is uninterrupted, it's meaningful, and is deep sleep. So there are a couple things you can do in this regard, and I'll probably make another video on how to get the best sleep possible. But you want to limit distractions and you want to create an environment that is really conducive to you feeling comfortable. And when you go to sleep and your head hits the pillow, you knock out. You don't want to be struggling to go to sleep at night because that will really throw off your day. On the physical note, we also want to talk about exercise. How is your body doing? How do you feel generally? Are you sluggish? Are you lethargic? You know, is your nutrition as good as it could be, right? Are you making improvements in that area? Are you finding a way to do some sort of exercise? Do you have an opportunity to go do certain treatments? You know, and a lot of times I don't think it's a money thing. I just think that we just don't think about these things. You know, a lot of us have a selfless mentality and we don't think about spending $40 to $60 to get a massage every month. We're probably thinking about what needs to be done and what needs to be taken care of. But I want you to start thinking about, even if it's not $40 to $60, maybe it's $20 to get a pedicure. Maybe it's $10 to do something, to get some sort of treatment where someone else can take care of the kinks, the rough edges, and kind of help you to feel your best, physically as well. And one of the last areas that I will talk about real quick is just the spiritual, just sort of where is your mind at, right? Do you have clarity of mind? Do you have peace of mind? Spend some time figuring out how to center yourself spiritually, how to get your mind to a place where it's not constantly bogged down by the next thing on the news or next craziness out there. If you're gonna allow the news and the next thing out there to dictate how you're gonna feel on a daily basis, you're constantly gonna be in a state of disarray, because that's what those things create. And those things are constantly in flux, and you don't wanna be constantly in flux. One of the most important ways to take care of your mind is to gain stability. You don't wanna be going to and fro. You don't want every wind and every piece of news to dictate your mood and your emotions. So you wanna still your mind. And so that takes intentionality and focus as well. So I hope that listening to this video has helped get you started thinking about how to incorporate self-care into your regular routine and regimen and making it an integral part of your day-to-day habits and your daily life. If you like this video, please don't forget to smash the like button. If you haven't subscribed to the channel already, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. And I will see you next time on Renaissance Life TV. Cheers.